WHDD Robin Hood Radio. I'm Jonathan H., and welcome to the School of Jazz. This is where we play you some of the great performances in jazz from the 1950s until present time. And in today's show, I'm going to play you some of the great performances that I listen to continually and have listened to for some 40 years. Those are the performances that I find myself going back to, enjoying and playing no matter what I'm doing, whether I'm listening directly or doing something else. These are the ones that I love and listen to the most, and I think you're going to enjoy them as well. So let's start right off with the very album, the very musicians that got me hooked on jazz, and that is Charles Mingus and Tijuana Moods. This album CD was done after Charles went to Tijuana, and this CD reflects his impressions of the area. It was done in 1962, and we're going to hear Flamingo, and you're going to hear Charles Mingus on bass. You're going to hear trombone Jimmy Nepper, alto sax Curtis Porter, and trumpetist Clarence Shaw, a brilliant trumpet player, piano Bill Triglia, drums Danny Richman, percussion Frankie Dunlap. Thank you.
Thank you.
Oh, yes. That was Charles Mingus from his CD album, Mingus Uh-Huh. And that was Better Get It In Your Soul. And that featured Charles Mingus as a leader and bass, John Handy alto saxophone, Booker Irvin tenor sax, and then Shafi Hadi on alto sax, and Jimmy Nepper on trombone. Horace Parlin was on piano, and Denny Richmond was on drums. And I played you that second Charles Mingus because it's a classic and something I listen to often. All right, well, let's move on, and we're going to move on to the next great jazz artist that I heard in college at that time, which was Bill Evans. And we're going to listen to his CD, Portrait in Jazz, the Bill Evans Trio, and we're going to hear his rendition of Autumn Leaves. And this features his great trio with Bill on piano, Scott LaFaro bass, Paul Modian drums. And this trio really did create something new. Before the trio appeared on the scene in the early 60s, you had great bebop piano players such as Bud Powell or Red Garland, Wynton Kelly. Those were great players, but the bass and the drums in those groups was a supporting cast, whereas with the Bill Evans Trio, you now had all three instruments interacting as one. So let's take a listen to Portrait in Jazz, the Bill Evans Trio, with their rendition of Autumn Leaves.
Thank you.
All right, so you heard from Chick Corea from his solo piano recording, Expressions, and you heard Armando's Rumba. That is something I listen to a lot. That's a gorgeous CD. And speaking of gorgeous CDs, just before that, you also heard from Chick Corea on piano with Gary Burton on Vibes, and you heard from their classic ECM release, Crystal Silence. And you heard the tune Crystal Silence. And just before that, you heard from Bill Evans and his CD Quintessence, and you heard the tune A Child Is Born. And that was Bill Evans on piano, Harold Land tenor sax, Kenny Burrell guitar, Ray Brown acoustic bass, and Philly Joe Jones drums. Great lineup, beautifully done, and that is something I listen to a lot. And as announced earlier, just before that, you heard Bill Evans' Portrait in Jazz. You're listening to WHDD Robin Hood Radio, and I'm Jonathan H. with the School of Jazz. If you like what you're hearing today, we'd really appreciate your support. And if you'd like to help support us and bring current programming and also additional National Public Radio, Public Radio International, American Public Media, and regional and local programming to WHDD, you can do so by making a tax-deductible donation. You can go to our website at robinhoodradio.com and under the Donate section, follow the directions, or if you wish, you can send a check to WHDD, 67 Main Street, Sharon, Connecticut, 06069, and you make your check out to Tri-State Public Communications Incorporated. That's Tri-State Public Communications Incorporated. And you can put the name of the show that you're supporting on the reference line there. All right, let's get back to the music, and we are going to hear a stunning performance by Lee Konitz and Warren Marsh. This is from the CD Lee Konitz Live at the Half Note, and it features Lee Konitz on alto saxophone, Warren Marsh on tenor sax, Bill Evans piano, Jimmy Garrison bass, and Paul Modian drums. And we're going to hear the tune Palo Alto. For those of you who don't know, Warren Marsh on tenor saxophone and Lee Konitz on alto sax were part of the school of Lenny Tristano, the pianist. And consequently, you're going to hear long lines of improvisation which explore the harmonies of the song. This particular performance demonstrates the height of this school. So let's take a listen to Lee Konitz and Warren Marsh live at the Half Note. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, Lee Konitz and Warren Marsh. All right, next we're going to hear Steve Kuhn, the pianist, and this is from his CD, Mostly Ballads, and we're going to hear the tune Erigen. And this is a CD I listen to a lot. Steve Kuhn was a Harvard graduate who played for a while with John Coltrane and forged his own career. He's a brilliant pianist. So let's take a listen to Steve Kuhn, Mostly Ballads. Listening to WHDD Robin Hood Radio, and this is Jonathan H. with the School of Jazz. And we're focusing here around the great jazz performances that I find myself listening to all the time and have listened to over the years. And the next one is a perfect example of something I've listened to maybe hundreds of times. It's Steve Kuhn on piano from his CD album October Suite, arranged and conducted by Gary McFarland. The album features a string quartet, which was arranged and conducted by Gary, and you hear Steve on piano, Ron Carter on bass, and Marty Morrell on drums. Why do I listen to this a lot? Well, I think it's not only because of the superb playing of Steve Kuhn himself, who is one of my favorite jazz pianists and has been for 35 years, but because of the fascinating contrast between the string quartet and the jazz trio. So here it is, One I Could Have Loved, with Steve Kuhn, arranged by Gary McFarland. All right, and that was Dizzy Gillespie, and you heard Dizzy Gillespie's album CD, A Portrait of Duke Ellington, and that was Caravan, and that is a CD I listen to all the time, and one of the main reasons is not just because of Dizzy's playing, but because of the arrangements, which are by the great Claire Fisher, one of my favorite arrangers of all time, and this thing I've been listening to since the 60s. And speaking of Claire Fisher and his arrangements, just before that, Dizzy Gillespie performance, you heard Claire Fisher and his big band, and you heard the tune Bittersweet, and that's from the original album Extension, and it is now available on a CD entitled Claire Fisher Piano and Orchestra, America the Beautiful. And that is gorgeous, and it also contains another album as well as Extension called America the Beautiful, which is also lovely. I highly recommend that CD, Claire Fisher, America the Beautiful. And just before that, you heard two of my favorite Chico Hamilton performances, both from the same album, Gongs East, with Eric Dolphy. And you heard Beyond the Blue Horizon, and then before that, you heard Gongs East. And that featured Chico Hamilton on drums, Dennis Buttermuir guitar, one of my favorite guitar players of all time, Eric Dolphy on alto sax, flute, and bass clarinet, Nathan Gershman on cello, and Wyatt Ruther on bass. Beautifully done. You're listening to WHDD Robin Hood Radio, and this is Jonathan H. with the School of Jazz. All right, so now we're going to play something I listen to continually, especially through the 60s, 70s, 80s, and 90s. And this was Lee Konitz with strings from his CD album, An Image. This was arranged and conducted by the great Chicago arranger, Bill Russo. And this album is gorgeous. It's haunting and beautiful. And we're going to hear the tune, Blues for Our Children. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
Oh boy, is that sweet. That is as good as it gets. And that was Carmel Jones on trumpet with his group from the early 60s. And that was I'm Gonna Go Fishing. And that was Carmel Jones on trumpet, Harold Land on tenor sax, Frank Strazzari on piano, Gary Peacock bass, and Leon Pettis drums, June 1961. And that's from the original album, The Remarkable Carmel Jones. And it has currently been reissued by Mosaic on Mosaic Select, Carmel Jones, 3 CDs in one box set. Strongly recommend you get that baby. All right, and before that, you heard the underground classic, Harold Land and the Fox. And you heard Harold Land on tenor saxophone, Dupre Bolton trumpet, Elmo Hope piano, Herbie Lewis bass, Frank Butler drums. And Dupre Bolton on trumpet is a wonderful trumpet player who made very few recordings. So this is a rare gem. And you heard the tune, The Fox, and the CD is also called The Fox, August 1959. This is WHDD Robin Hood Radio, and I'm Jonathan H. with the School of Jazz. We hope you're enjoying the program as much as we enjoy bringing it to you. All righty, so we're going to wind this all up here with Charles Lloyd, the tenor saxophonist from his stunning album, Of Course, Of Course. And we're going to hear 2 tunes in a row from him. We're going to hear Of Course, Of Course, and we're going to hear the song My Lady Sings. And this features Charles Lloyd on tenor sax, Gabor Szabo on guitar, and you'll hear he's a very unusual and original guitar player. Ron Carter bass and Tony Williams drums. A stellar rhythm section, a fascinating album. This is on Mosaic, and it's called Of Course, Of Course, the Charles Lloyd Quartet. Sit back and enjoy.